Women know nothing about love.
Ella no sabe nada.
This is why I am here. Fernando grows tired of hearing women on the radio with bad advice. Because if you close your eyes, you can be loving anyone, especially when you are alone on an airplane bathroom and people are knocking on the door and you keep flushing and flushing. Let's take a caller. Who's hot?
Raise up, dude!
Hello, Carl. Been a long time, huh?
Yeah, I was starting to miss you guys.
Now, why don't I believe you? Get over here! Now, things have developed since the last time we met. Despite our best efforts, the gig's nearly up.
I'm sure you'll find some way to keep your badge. Your kind always do.
You still don't get it, do you, Carl? This ain't about keeping some fucking badge!
Hey, listen to the man.
We all the same, Carl. You, me. We all trying to pull ourselves out of the hole. Somebody steps on me, I gotta step on you.
Where's Hernandez with that fucking meat? He's been gone too long, Tenpenny.
Getting a little edgy, fellas?
Oh! How you like that, you piece of shit? That give you any idea how edgy I am?
Whoa! What the fuck?
Get up, bitch! You paying attention? Now, there's a ruined town out west of here. Aldea Malvada. And there's some piece of shit DEA officer meeting with an FBI agent with a dossier. Now, you get the dossier, and you make both of them disappear.
Not getting any younger here.
Wait.
To get paid, to get high.
Yeah, I was undercover smoking crack every day. You know, just to be one of them. I even took my wife undercover and made her a crack whore. Say hello to the newsman, bitch.
Hey, don't I know you? The rusty trombone, right?
I doubt it, tramp. You're crazy. Back to you, Leanne.
Police are struggling to solve the mystery of a container ship found deserted and full of bodies. The FBI is investigating. And government officials denied the existence of an area of Bone County that isn't on the map. Someone who was unprepared to be named said, the so-called place that isn't called anything doesn't exist. And if it did, we'd name it something. And where is Mad Dog, wonder record execs? The rapper has battled alcoholism. Desert, then it was a mob town. Now it's the corporate headquarters of America. Richard explains from the streets.
That's right, Leanne. It used to be a patch of desert. Then it was a mob town. Now it is the corporate headquarters of America. Back to you in the studio.
In foreign news, we have war, famine, pestilence, and a lot of envy aimed at our way of life. Stay at home. It's better that way. I'm Leanne Forget, WCTR News. Stay alert. They're after us.
This is well-known philanthropist Big Smoke, and you're listening to WCTR. Make a difference to your community. Keep our cities drug-free. Look, I'm doing my bit. How are you helping?
Oh, excuse me. This is a supermarket. You two need to get a room.
No, we don't. Renegade.
Oh, God. You smell incredible. Maybe I'll join in.
Renegade cologne. For the man who wants to wreak on masculinity. Nobody tells a renegade what to do.
Sir, that tree is not a bathroom.
Oh.
Ow, not my shoes!
Renegade. The renegade man goes where he wants. For the smell of an individual, it's renegade.
Or instead of renegade, try sweat. The cologne for the animal inside. It's real sweat. Because nothing attracts women like a sweaty man.
The most boring show with a brand new host. Entertaining America with Laszlo.
Welcome to Entertaining America on WCTR with me, Laszlo. So, the media. You may hate us, but I'm gonna tell you, we hate ourselves more. And stop accusing us of being liberal. What a load of crap. This station is owned by Ammunition. I mean, have you ever heard anyone complain about guns on this station? Hosts are getting shot by them all the time, and it just gets glossed over. I now have a job. If you're afraid of your mortality and never want to die, here's the solution. It's a man who's got all of America talking with his unique approach to spiritual matters. He's helped thousands, or so the press pack tells me. Chris Formage, founder of the Epsilon Program, is here. Hello, Chris.
Kiflam, brother.
What does that mean, man? So, Epsilonism, is it a load of crap, or is it the future?
Well, what do you think, Laszlo?
I don't know. Well, I mean, I grow my own religion. Well, I don't know. It's kind of spaced out. I mean, but you guys run around chanting lip balm.
It's Kiflam.
Well, whatever. Both sound addictive to me. You know, only popular people are addicted to either. Let's go to the phones.
Hey, Chris, Epsilon sounds awesome. But if you read the fossil record, punch to death.
Is that? Yes, obviously.
Then why do you mock the happiness of others?
Well, I mean, this is Vinewood. We're all supposed to be like psycho.
Roller coaster! too low out. Niggas going crazy.
Surgery, whatever you want. Lie with 9 new partners a week.
It explains everything.
If there are no women, make them. From sand, from garbage, out of thin air. The rich cry too, Laszlo.
Well, that's an interesting theory that sounds like it was formulated with pharmaceuticals. But, you know, I would like to find about being rich and crying. Because right now I'm just poor and crying. But this is the West Coast, you know. I'm only into lesbians, man.
It's destiny.
Vinewood only lets you down. In the Epsilon program, there are no series finales.
Great, first show and a dude nearly killed me. Now I'm being harassed by a former sociology professor and an alcoholic turned self-deifying cultist. Please, I gotta get back to the East Coast. This has been Entertaining America with Laszlo on WCTR.
Culturally, this country is flatlining. Now you know why. If you're into exploring exotic places and forbidden fruit, stay tuned. It's The Wild Traveler. Next.
Hello, I'm James Bediston, World Traveler, and this is The Wild Traveler. From Peru to San Andreas in 8 days by balloon. Often while lounging around garden parties, we forget the brave workers worldwide who toil day and night for the products we consume. Some are even so dedicated to our happiness, they carry products in balloons shoved inside themselves to be a balloon. This prize. We go to the phones. Yes, we do.
I can't believe you actually recommended we go to Barbados on our honeymoon. It was revolting. You were poor people. I live in Vinewood to be away from poor people.
Barbados is lovely.
Look, I want to be very clear. I'm not racist. Just careful.
Okay.
I like all-inclusive resorts where you can drink as much as you want, be around other people from San Andreas, and the only interaction you have with the locals is if you need a cocktail or some spice in the bedroom with your husband.
Well, that's...
Defecate in their living rooms and cover it up with dirt like a cat. You can't find a decent starlet anywhere. Or a good chicken wing. And the strippers? Overcharge.
Good Lord, you're philistine. You should stay out of England. I hear there is a casino in Ventura's that is just like the rest of the world, only with better toilets and full of morons like you. Do you want culture or do you want safety? It's your choice. Personally, I want irrigation. Come on in, quiet. Let's go to the phones. Who's on the phones? No one? Come on! Call up! Anyone? It wouldn't be like this in the pool, I can tell you. There I once made a phone call with 30 boys sitting on my lap. Not because I paid them. They wanted to be there. Or in Mali, where nobody knows what a phone is. And a lot of people have never even heard of plastic surgery. Or the...